I've recently upgraded to an iPhone 17 Pro, and like any normal person, I've watched every review and YouTube video before making the call. And even if you haven't watched every video, you've probably heard about the scratchgate. Some people claim that the anodized aluminum of the iPhone 17 Pro scratches way too easily, especially around the camera bump. Since we've been using anodized aluminum in our keyboards for years, I thought it would be interesting to explain how aluminum is anodized and shed some light on the scratchgate from a manufacturer's perspective. Let's start from the top. Why is aluminum anodized in the first place? Anodizing converts the surface of aluminum into a hard, corrosion-resistant layer of aluminum oxide, commonly referred to as alumina. Alumina is up to 9H on the Mohs scale of mineral hardness, close to sapphire. Unlike paint or plating, the oxide layer is grown from the metal itself. It becomes part of the surface, rather than just sitting on top. Kind of like the thing from the Fantastic Four. And yet, we've all seen the images of the scratches on the iPhone. So why does this happen? That has to do with the anodizing process and the design choices that the Apple engineers made. Let's see how aluminum is anodized. Anodizing is the final step in the process on creating any aluminum component. For our keyboards, it all starts as a flat aluminum sheet that's die-cut and stabbed into the shape of the top panel. Next, we die-cut the holes for the switches, add internal supports for the screws, and CNC the recesses for the low-profile switches, the battery, and the magnets for the pulp pads. Then, every edge is manually sanded to remove imperfections, and the entire piece is sandblasted to achieve a soft matte texture that you can see here on the side. Finally, we brush the top surface in one direction to get that distinctive finish. Only then is it ready for anodizing. The first step of anodizing is a pre-treatment process that removes grease or oils from the surface. Basically, you wash the aluminum piece with soap. Then, it's rinsed to remove any excess detergent and proceeds to the next stage, which involves a caustic or acid etch that removes minor imperfections and creates a uniform surface ideal for anodizing. Next, it's rinsed again to remove any residue from the etch process. Now, the aluminum piece is submerged in a tank of sulfuric acid electrolyte while an electric current is passed through the solution. Oxygen ions are released to combine the aluminum atoms of the surface, creating aluminum oxide. Anodizing is basically a form of controlled oxidation. We are literally rusting it on purpose to create a material that is harder and resistant to corrosion, because you can't rust what's already rusted. This anodic coating grows both into the metal and outward, forming a fully integrated shell of protection. After anodization, the aluminum is rinsed again in deionized water. Now is the moment where you can add color. The anodic coating is a porous structure. If you submerge the piece into a dye solution, the pores will absorb the dye. This is called dye coloring, which is the most common method for achieving any hue. The drawback is that it can fade slightly under UV light. For our black keyboards, we use electrolytic coloring instead of dye. An electric current deposits metal salts inside the pores. That creates deep, rich tones that never fade. The longer the time in the electrolytic bath, the darker and intense the color. Apple's bright finishes like Cosmic Orange or Pacific Blue are almost certainly dye-based because electrolytic coloring can't produce vivid hues like this. We also use dye coloring for the limited edition colors of our keyboards, such as Royal Purple, Egyptian Gold, Atlantis Blue, or Daredevil Red. The final step is sealing the porous surface using a solution of nickel acetate. This ensures that the color is integral to the material. So now that we know how aluminum is anodized and how well it protects it, why does the iPhone scratch so easily? Let's explain the scratchgate. The answer lies in the design decisions. The camera bump has very sharp corners, which means there is less surface area for the oxide layer to grow evenly. As a result, the protective coating ends up thinner and more likely to scratch. That's where Apple's design choices meet the limits of physics. This is something that we purposely avoided when designing the top panel for our keyboards. You'll notice that the corners are rounded, and wherever there's a sharp edge, another element protects it, like where the top panel meets the base. Even the holes for the switches are slightly chamfered to prevent scratches, and the sandblasting and brushing also help smooth out any sharp edges. Of course, even a flat anodized surface, like the top panel, can be scratched. If you apply pressure with a sharp metal object, like a key, you will scratch it. But the anodizing should protect it from normal pressure from sharp objects, and also hard pressure from rounded objects, like a coin. You see, we didn't scratch it. That's why we even modified the keycap and switch puller that we provide with the keyboard. Its edges are rounded and less likely to scratch the surface if you are not careful. So it's not just about the anodizing process, it's about how you design for it. And that's it. That's why the iPhone's camera bump scratches. It's not bad anodizing, just sharp edges. If you liked our limited edition keyboards, check them out at dygma.com/colors. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and tell us which color you would pick, or if you've already scratched your iPhone. See you in the next one!